Welcome to SEIKA Machinery here at SMTA International. Delighted to be joined by Charlie Fujikawa.
Yep.
Nice to see you, Charlie.
Good to be here.
Okay. So you got a new PCB cleaner here beside us. It's a Unitemp PCB cleaner.
Yep.
Generally speaking, when you get these PCB cleaners, it's just a sticky roller.
Mm-hmm.
But this is a three-phase cleaner.
Yes.
Can you talk us through how it works?
Yeah. So again, three-phase. So the first phase here is a nylon brush and vacuum system.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's housed under here, but it's hard to see. The nylon brush here gets lowered down on top of the PCB, and it pulls up any particulates. And the vacuum system on top pulls that and then
puts them down into a chamber at the bottom.
Correct.
So that's looking for the large particulates.
Yeah, especially larger particulates, and also any particulates that are embedded in any channels or routed out portions.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, and the other good thing, I guess, by the brushes is you get into any channels or any recesses inside the board.
Correct.
That
sort of thing. Yeah.
So after it's done that, it moves on to the next part.
So the next cleaning mechanism here, this is a silicone rubber roller.
Mm-hmm.
And as the PCB passes under here, any remaining particulates get pulled off of the surface of the PCB by this rubber roller, and it gets transferred onto this tape roller on top. And then the tape roller basically is like a big lint brush where you can pull off the outer layer and cut it off. So you can always keep it fresh and always keep your rollers clean.
Right, so you do that manually, you pull it off and,
correct,
and cut it. Okay, excellent. So that's the second level of cleaning.
Yes. And the third here on the end, we could actually put these on both the front and the rear, but it's a ionized air knife.
Okay.
And so what that's doing is basically just blowing air on top of the surface of the PCB, just getting any remaining dust or particles. And then because it's ionized, what it's doing is it's cutting down the actual Static electricity.
Yeah, it's making it ESD safe. Yeah.
Correct.
Right.
So that nothing gets pulled onto the board between the cleaner and the stencil machine.
Right. Okay. So a pretty comprehensive cleaning system.
Yeah.
So that's great. So you've also got another new machine over in another part of the booth, which we're going to look at now, which is a PCB router.
Yes.
Okay. So now we're over at the PCB router, then, and I'm with the product manager, who is Max Bernard. Nice to see you, Max.
Nice to see you.
Okay, so tell us, what are the key benefits of using this machine? Let's get it right. It's the Sayaka CT34XJ.
Yep. Some of the main benefits are easy ability to work with a cobot. The sliding forward table makes it a lot easier for operators to load and unload.
Mm-hmm.
The integrated camera, which allows you to teach it right online, makes it very simple to use, point and click operation. It's extremely repeatable, extremely quick, and there's very little dust. It's all pulled out through dust collection from the fixture from below.
Right, okay, so let's go through some of these bits. So easy programming, point and click.
Yep.
It can be either manual or semi-automatic. Is that using an external robot, or how does that work?
Yeah. So depending on if you want to have a robotic loader or a human loader, it'll bring out the fixture, you load in your PCB, and then it'll start. You can have it do automatic operation where it'll scan the QR code on the fixture and adjust the cutting program as necessary. And with the onboard camera, it can also check the fiducials and adjust the program if there are any misalignments.
Right. Okay, so looking at the bits themselves, I mean, what sort of range of auger bits do you have?
So we use a downdraft router bit, so it'll force any of the dust and debris down through the fixture. And we have the range of 0.8 to 2.3 millimeter.
Okay.
Which will allow you to cut up to a 6 millimeter thick board.
Right. It's quite decent. So to get rid of the debris, there is a sort of channel which you can barely see underneath the board there. So is that's got a suction device underneath it?
That's correct. We have a standalone dust collector separate from the machine, and it pulls all the dust and debris downward through the fixture into the collection bin.
All right, so there's a separate collection bin that sits beside the machine.
That's correct.
In the factory. Okay. What about the speed of the routing itself?
So we get a traverse speed of about 800 millimeters a second and a maximum cutting speed of around 50 millimeters a second.
Right.
So depending on your board material and thickness, you can adjust as necessary.
Yeah. Okay. Great. Okay, so there we have it. That's the Sayaka CT34XJ. Max, thank you very much for showing it to us today.
Thank you.